A warm welcome to the introductory session on the JRE verbal section. On the JRE verbal section, you have two sections, 30 minutes per section, 20 questions per section. So in those two sections, you have 20 questions per section of 30 minutes each, and then you have a score scale of 130 to 170. Where 130 is your minimum score and 170 is your maximum possible score. Now, there are three basic question types on the verbal section. The first one is a sentence equivalence. A sentence equivalence has four questions. This is a fill-in-the-blank question with a single blank. A text completion has six questions, which can vary from a single blank or to a double or a triple blank question. But these are again fill-in-the-blank questions. And the last question type is a reading comprehension. The reading comprehension has 10 questions where they ask, give you a passage and they ask you to answer the questions based on those passages. Now let's look at sentence equivalence and text completion in terms of the question formats. The first one here that you see on the screen is sentence equivalence. Now sentence equivalence, you have a single blank question and they ask you to choose two answer choices out of six which are alike in meaning or which create two sentences which are alike in meaning. So with this question type, you will always see six options and you will always see check boxes. Now let's look at the sentence. The sentence says a field trip was arranged for some kind of a band so that they could learn from the virtuosi of music. Like you see on the screen, the virtuosi of music are people who are skilled in music. Now, if they are skilled in music, then what kind of a band would want to learn from them? It must be someone who is a beginner. So we want an option which means beginner. Now let's look at the options. The first one that we see there is mediocre. Mediocre means average. This can't be our answer because it doesn't really match our anticipated answer, which was beginner. Secondly, mediocre also does not have a pair in the remaining options, which is another reason why we can eliminate mediocre. The next two options are famous and popular. Now, if we think about it, famous and popular, bands will probably not want to learn from experts, mainly because they are already good at it, they're famous or popular, and so probably not our answer, so we can eliminate these two options. The next two words are fledgling and novice. Now, fledgling and novice do mean beginner, which does match our anticipated answer. So these are definitely two options that we want to keep. And then the last option is mundane. Mundane means ordinary. We can eliminate this because it doesn't match our anticipated answer. Also because it does not have a pair that goes with it. So what we are left with is fledgling and novice. And these are our final answers. Now, another important thing to keep in mind when it comes to sentence equivalence is that there are no marks for partially correct answers, which means you have to get both the options right to get a point. Now let's look at the next question type. The next question type is a text completion single blank. Now, with text completion single blank, you have to select one option. Now, this one option must complete the sentence given and for which they give you five options. Of these five options, we have to select one answer choice. So, unlike a sentence equivalence that we saw earlier, where you had six options and check boxes and you had to select two answer choices. Now, unlike this, in a text completion single blank, you have to select only one answer choice that best completes the given text. Now, look at the sentence. The sentence says, all brilliant writers use satire to something and not conceal the problems prevalent in our society. So, what do they use satire for? They use satire to something and not conceal. So if they are not concealing, then they are using it. So they're using sarcasm, they're using satire to show the problems prevalent in our society. So we want an option that means show. Now look at the options. Reveal sounds good, so we're going to keep reveal for now. Then we have interpret and mock, which can be easily eliminated because it doesn't match our anticipated answer. The last two words are difficult words. We don't really know the meaning of those two words probably, but what we do know is that reveal matches our anticipated answer, and so as of this moment we can eliminate these two options and mark reveal as the correct answer choice. So what the sentence at the end of the day, what it means is that the brilliant writers use writing or use sarcasm to expose or reveal the problems of society. Now let's look at the two words that we didn't know the meaning of. So discombobulate means confuse. Extirpate means completely wipe out or eliminate, which clearly does not match our anticipated answer. Now, based on these two questions, I'm sure you've noticed that you came across a few words at least that you did not know the meaning of. So you were either unfamiliar with them or really unfamiliar with them. And so for this, it becomes extremely important that you start learning words from any of the vocabulary apps like the Oaks vocabulary app. So the app will give you meanings, they'll give you sample sentences, images and pictures around it, so that it helps you learn more words in a shorter duration and words which are relevant for the GRE. Now let's look at the double blank question. Now in a double blank question, you have two blanks and you have to complete. So you have to select one answer choice per blank. So if you see, there are three answer choices for blank one and three answer choices for blank two. And you have to select one blank, one answer choice per blank. Again, the important thing to keep in mind is there are no marks for partially correct answers. The last question type is a text completion triple blank, where exactly like a double blank, you will see three options per blank. The only difference is now you will see one additional blank and an additional set of options for the third blank. So again, you're going to select one answer choice per blank. Any question type where they ask you to select more than one answer, so whether it was sentence equivalence or a double blank text completion or a triple blank text completion like the one you see on the screen, remember there will never be partial marking, so you have to get every single option right to get a point. Now let's look at reading comprehension and the question formats for reading comprehension. Now reading comprehension, this is your first question format, which is a single select. In a single select question format, you have five options and you have to select one answer choice, and so you see radio buttons. So radio buttons will allow you to choose only one answer. Now this question type asks you to best summarize the author's primary purpose. So at this point, I suggest that you pause the video, take a look at the passage, and then we'll discuss the passage. Now if you look at the passage, the first part of the passage talks about murals. Then the next part of the passage talks about how they were traditionally. So it describes the murals a little further. And finally, the last part of the passage talks about how they are today. So it talks about the current and says today acrylics are often used to paint murals rather than oils, which were almost universally used less than a century ago. So it tells us how things have changed. Now let's look at the options based on this. We want the author's primary purpose, which means the author's reason for writing the passage. Now if you look at the options, option C says it is an art form, which is true because it's talking about murals, and briefly overview, which is also true because the author is giving a brief overview of the art form. So C is the correct answer choice here. Now let's also look at the remaining answer choices. A says it is a piece of art, and the The rest of the option says to analyze a piece of art, which is not the case. The author is not analyzing a piece of art, so A can be eliminated. B says to describe a historical development, but this is not a historical development that the author is talking about, so B can be eliminated. D says to show constantly shifting trends. So there is a shift of trend that the passage does talk about when it talks about murals versus acrylics. But the passage doesn't really talk about constantly shifting trends, and that's not the purpose of the passage. So D can be eliminated. And E says to cast doubt on previous techniques, but previous techniques are not discussed, and definitely the author is not trying to cast doubt or weaken any of the previous techniques. So E can be eliminated, and which is again why C is our answer. Now let's look at the next question type, which is a multiple select. In a multiple select question type, you will see three options and you will see check boxes. So you have to select all those that appropriately answer the question. Now of these three options, now this is what the question stem says. It can be inferred from the passage that the author would most likely agree with which of the following statements. So let's look at each of these options. The first one says it is possible to define murals, which is what the first part of the passage does, in terms of size, which is again what the passage does tell us when it says large scale, and finally technique, which is what we see when the passage says usually executed directly on walls and ceilings. So A can be marked as a correct answer choice. B says techniques for painting murals have never changed. Now that's not true, because the passage tells us today acrylics are often used to paint murals rather than oils. So never changed is clearly wrong, because it does talk about a change in the passage. So B can be eliminated. C says murals are not a recent art form, which is true, because the passage tells us it is among the oldest forms of human art. So this is also supported by the passage, and we can mark that as an answer. Now, like I told you earlier with the fill in the blank questions, any question that allows you to select more than one answer, remember there will not be partial marking. So there won't be any marks for partially correct answers. You have to get all the options right to get a point. Now our next question type is a highlighted portion. In a highlighted portion, you could have a single word highlighted like the one that you see here. You could also have an entire phrase or a sentence highlighted, or you could even have two sentences highlighted where they ask you the relationship between the two sentences. Now in this case, it's asking us for the meaning of the word executed in context of the passage. So the passage says that they are large-scale paintings usually executed directly on walls and ceilings. Now the first option can clearly be eliminated, because murals can't be killed directly on walls and ceilings, so that's clearly wrong. So is carried out, because the passage doesn't really say that they are carried out directly on walls and ceilings. Done sounds good for now, so it's not a very great option, but it's a little vague, but it definitely works in this context, because the murals can definitely be done directly on ceilings or walls. Seen and admired can clearly be eliminated, because we're not talking about seeing or admiring those paintings directly on walls and ceilings, but we're talking about executing them, and which is why done is our correct answer choice given the options. The last question type is a select sentence in the passage, where instead of options, so you don't really see options, instead they ask you to select a sentence in the passage itself that answers the question asked. So what you see on the screen is the question stem, where they give you directions or description that is required to answer the question, or select a sentence that answers that. So the question stems says, select the sentence in the passage that points out a shifting of trends. Now let's look at the passage again. We want a shift of trends. The first part of the passage talks about the murals. Then we have something which talks about how it was traditionally. And then we see the shift where it talks about today. So if the question stem asks us about the shifting of trends, this is going to be our correct answer choice. So we have seen all the question types for sentence equivalence, question, text completions and reading comprehension. So we've seen all the question formats that you could possibly see on the GRE verbal section. If you've liked this video, do definitely take a free GRE test on the website so you know where you stand. View all the blogs that we have. They are extremely useful and informative. Look at or watch the videos on the website or watch the videos on YouTube as well. And finally, you can also enroll for a demo lecture, a free demo lecture, so that you can attend one of the classes and see how it is. Thank you for watching. See you in class.